In this video, we'll see the steps required to clone a Smart IT production environment on a test environment for Smart IT version 18.x and above. If you wish to install a copy of production system on a lower environment, there are a couple of configurations that we need to modify to prevent the test system from accidentally connecting to production AR server, OpenFire or Smart IT backend databases. The recommendation would be to uninstall Smart IT completely on the duplicated environment and perform a fresh Smart IT installation using the new server names. Alternatively, the AR server name must be modified at certain places, so let's check each of those. First is your Smart IT SQL database, which will have the tables called Smart IT System Configuration Parameter and the provider settings. Configuration parameter table contains the host name, the remedy application service password, and the port number of your AR server. So you have to make sure that it points to your new server and not to the production system. Second is the provider settings table. Check for the entries where key name is like host. So you may use a query like this to result the relevant records. So you have to make sure that you change the host name to point to your new server. Next is the SMT administration console, which was earlier known as MyIT administration console. So you will see the old server listed on the applications like BMC MyIT, MyIT ITSM and MyIT HRCM. So you have to make sure that it points to the correct AR server. For that, you can add your new AR server under the persistent data store with the correct host name, remedy application service password, and port number of your new server. After saving it, you need to select your new AR server that you've added using this drop-down and save the changes. And this change needs to be done for all the three applications: BMC MyIT, MyIT ITSM, and MyIT HRCM. Next, your OpenFire chat parameters needs to be updated. So that you can do from the centralized configuration. Select the component name as Smart IT. Here, update the server URL to point the OpenFire instance to correct SQL database instance for the cloned environment. So parameters like chat server CM host, Bosch URL, these all should point to your new server. Next is the OpenFire admin console. Under Server Manager System Properties, there are a couple of parameters that you need to change. First is the XMPP domain, which must match the chat server CM host parameter that you have specified in the centralized configuration. Second is the provider auth auth resource, which should refer the new host name or load balancer for the cloned Smart IT instance. If you have this parameter called admin.authorizedJIDs available, modify it to match the cloned OpenFire XMPP domain. If you are using OpenFire with SSL, add the suitable SSL certificates under the TLS SSL certificates tab. In addition to this, go to the JRE lib security directory of the Java being used by the cloned Smart IT instance and add the new OpenFire SSL certificate for the clone system in this CA-cert file. If using Hazelcast plugin for OpenFire clustering, update the member entries in the hazelcast-local-config.xml file to match the cloned OpenFire instances. There are a few other Smart IT parameters that needs to be modified. First is your smartit.xml file, which was earlier known as ux.xml. It is located under your Smart IT Tomcat Conf Catalina localhost directory. This file contains references to the JDBC database connection of both schemas, Smart IT system and Smart IT business. So you have to make sure that you update both the references with your new AR server. This file also contains the DB username passwords for this connection. If using Smart IT with SSL, add suitable SSL certificate to a keystore file that is referenced within the Smart IT Tomcat's server.xml file, which is located under your Smart IT Tomcat's conf directory. Thank you for watching.